So recently, I demonstrated how I was able to add hook flash functionality to this Polycom IP phone by an asterisk detecting long stars essentially and converting them into a hook flash event. And while this does work, it turns out that there is an interesting negative side effect of this that can make it undesirable to use. What I discovered was that certain calls I would find that the other party with whom I was connected, so we might be on a call and then I would flash, and I think in the scenario where I remember it happening, I was trying to make a three-way call to bring something into the call. When I came back, I could hear the other party, but he could not hear me. And so I thought that was odd. And I'm not 100% positive about it, but I think what's happening is that the way that this feature works, that I set it up to work at least, is that so DTMF with SIP is often relayed and regenerated essentially. So there will be a DTMF start, and then it'll be emulated for some amount of time, and then there will be a DTMF end, which is all well and good. The problem is that when there's a DTMF start, you only know that it's starting, so you don't know how long it's going to be. So at that point, I don't know if it's going to be just a regular star, or if it's longer than some user set time, then it might turn into a hook flash. So at that time, we can decide, okay, this is a hook flash, drop the star. Don't send a DTMF end for this, because that will actually cause the star to get registered on the far end. So, which might be fine, but it might be undesirable, because otherwise, essentially, if the other party was flashing, then you would just hear star DTMF coming at you all the time, which is probably not super desirable. So that gets dropped. The problem is that certain equipment seems to wait perpetually for the end DTMF, meaning that when they get a start DTMF, they seem to just cut audio towards them. So you don't hear the DTMF as the user over there. But since I never send the end DTMF, they're pretty much waiting in silence forever. So the result is that as soon as I use this feature, they basically never get audio from my end of the call again. So that is, to say the least, somewhat of an inconvenience. So what I've done is I've just simply gone ahead and, the star functionality was fine, but I thought I might as well just go all the way here and make real hook flashing work instead. And by real hook flashing, I mean using the actual hook switch to do hook flashing. And this works because with a Polycom phone and probably most IP phones as well, since they're not designed to use the hook switch for anything really other than hanging up, the split instant that you go on hook, these actually do go on hook, and they tear down the SIP call. So essentially, and in contrast to an ATA really, which is a little bit ironic, is you can actually get the more or less the authentic hook state of the IP phone on the server side. So what I've done is I've essentially, instead of relying on the SIP endpoint, like with an ETA, to convey that a hook flash occurred and then handle it on the switch, what I'm doing is I'm instead not really relying on the IP phone at all for anything. I'm instead determining if a hook flash has occurred by monitoring the hook status on the server and then basically processing it as needed, as if a hook flash had occurred. So from a user perspective, it works actually exactly the same way as if this were an analog phone. So to demonstrate, I've just got this coming through a speaker here, so you can see or hear exactly what I'm hearing here. So if I go off hook, there we go. So I call myself here. Okay, so I've given myself a call. Okay, so that's one stable call up. Now, as opposed to using the phone to do any kind of bridging or using that star button like I was before, I can simply go ahead and just like that, I've got a recall dial tone from the server. So, it has picked up that I have done a hook flash. So I can call a number here. And if we put this on speaker, so I'll hook flash again, which will conference the call. Alright. And if I flash again, and that drops the three-way party. So, so that's demonstrating it with three-way calling. And let me turn that speaker off so that's not echoing back here. So yeah, that's how it works. I am able to actually time pretty nicely the actual on-hook duration of going on hook, and essentially if I go back off hook within a certain amount of time, then I have a timer set so that if it's within that time, then it will process that as a hook flash. If it's beyond that, then it will just process it as a normal hang up. So it's essentially a sticky hang up in a way, and again the timing works pretty well. I imagine if you had network congestion or packet loss or something else in the middle, then that could potentially cause issues with the timing. Because, again, SIP wasn't really designed to do this. But it's actually worked very reliably for me, and so I'm quite happy with how it's turned out.